I've got to be honest, I really didn't like Beast Boy when I first started watching Teen Titans. His childish and foolish nature was something that I found deeply irritating. As a result, I instantly related to Raven's clear dislike for him. Couple that with her mysterious and complex persona, and the fact that being gothic seems better suited to being a villain than a hero, Raven was my favourite character from the moment I started watching this show, and that never changed the whole time I was watching. The way I felt about Beast Boy, however, has changed a lot. At first, I couldn't understand what enjoyment I was supposed to get out of watching him. I loved his power, but watching him as a person was not something I looked forward to. However, over time, I came to realize that this show isn't just a superhero show. It's a show about a group of friends that live together, and on top of that, they are teenagers or young adults, and they are at that age where it's all about your social status and fitting in. It's that time of your life when there are all kinds of different and complex things going on in your head about making friends and getting people to like you. Beast Boy is one of those people that isn't really sure what to do in order to better fit in, but is still desperate to do so. As a result, in an effort to try and fit in, he just tries anything and everything, and this has the side effect of annoying everyone. The reason this works is because people like this do exist. In fact, I was one of them at school. I would try to crack jokes or say things I thought were clever. And because they weren't, for the most part, people just tried to distance themselves from me. But I also knew people like this myself, so I know how annoying this type of person can be. I'm pretty sure everyone wants to yell at them to shut up, but we are all too polite to do so. I can completely relate to what Beast Boy is trying to do here, but I can also relate to the irritation Raven and the rest of the Titans feel. This is what I admired at first about Raven. She does have the guts at times to tell Beast Boy to shut up with her own clever put-downs. But what's interesting is that Beast Boy seems to make more of an effort to be friends with Raven than he does any other member of the team. Why would he make such an effort with Raven, the person that appears to like him the least, and also seems the least interested in making friends? Simple. Beast Boy feels that Raven is the type of person that needs friends most of all. She has shut herself away for so long, she maybe doesn't understand the value of having someone to turn to when you need help. It's also clear that, despite often being irritated by him, Raven does care about Beast Boy deep down. In more perilous and serious situations, Raven has shown real concern for Beast Boy, and she has saved him a number of times. However, at the same time, there is definitely a lot of tension between the two of them on the surface. Even when Beast Boy saves the lives of the whole team in Wavelength, Raven merely remarks about his bad breath, and when he saves Raven in Masks, he actually teases her about it. One of the most interesting scenes between these two is in The Beast Within, where Beast Boy says something to Raven that I'd actually been thinking for a while. But he's been a perfectly nice guy, and yet she still feels the need to insult him from time to time. And then at the end of this episode, she talks to him about becoming more of a man, so maybe this attitude from Raven is an attempt to stop Beast Boy from acting so childish, to toughen him up a little, learn that the world isn't all fun and games, and that people will try to hurt you emotionally. Robin seems to be the one that Raven typically turns to for help. However, there have been times when Beast Boy has gone to her when he thinks she needs help. Now, of course, I can't talk about these two without mentioning the famous hug scene, which is a really fascinating scene. See, during this episode, Raven thought she had finally discovered someone who actually understood her, the wizard Malkior, only to find that it was all a lie and he was merely using her. Convinced that she is alone once again, Raven shuts herself in her room and Beast Boy comes to tell her that even though the others may not understand her strange ways, that doesn't mean that they are not still her friends, and if she is willing to embrace that fact, she could be a lot more content in life. Beast Boy gets through to Raven here, hence she chooses to take part in the game of Stankball that Cyborg interrupts them with. I believe the hug is more of an expression of gratitude for helping her to see this than an act of love. Now, I have heard some people suggest that Beast Boy can't be in love with Raven because he's already in love with Terra. Oh, and I suppose Starfire can't be in love with Robin because she's already in love with Aqualad. It is possible to be in love with more than one person, you know. But with that said, Beast Boy's crush on Terra certainly did complicate things. It is very obvious that he is in love with Terra. Even when her disloyalty is revealed, he is still shown to be heartbroken at having lost her. So if his love for Terra is this obvious, wouldn't any possible love for Raven also be obvious? Well, not if Beast Boy doesn't actually realize it himself yet. It is possible to know someone for a while before actually realizing that you are in love with them. The fact that Beast Boy fell in love with Terra right away kind of suggests he only loves her for what she looks like, one reason why I've never liked the idea of love at first sight. But with Raven, maybe he loves her for her personality. He has done a lot of nice things for her that do seem to go beyond that simple act of friendship. Looking up her birthday, throwing a surprise party for her, and giving her his lucky penny for examples. Of course, this is more likely just an example of how nice a guy Beast Boy is, generally speaking. He would probably have done this for Robin, Cyborg, and Starfire as well. In fact, we see in Forces of Nature how awful Beast Boy feels when Starfire falls out with him. Beast Boy just values all his friends, and Raven is simply no exception to that. Now, the question of if Raven is in love with Beast Boy is a bit more difficult, as Raven does like to keep her emotions bottled up. In fact, we learn in Swapped that she kind of has to do this. We also learn in Fear itself that she doesn't like to admit to being scared. So it would make sense she wouldn't want to admit to feelings of love either. But I don't think Raven is really the type who would fall in love with anyone, really. In fact, that fawning over Aqualad when she first meets him seemed very out of character for her. I have heard some people suggest that the reason she is the most skeptical of Terra when she first joins the team is because she's jealous. That, to me, really detracts a lot of the real substance to that story arc. Suddenly, the whole question about if Terra can be trusted, as well as Raven being less open to people she doesn't know, is now just a jealousy story and a case of two girls fighting over a boy. I'm sorry, but Raven isn't that shallow and narrow-minded. She would have at least spoken to Terra if she was just jealous of her. I also think that the theory that she is jealous, and another theory that she is only pretending to hate Beast Boy to hide her real feelings, is just a case of fans seeing what they want to see. Neither of those seem like the type of things Raven would do. She may be mysterious, but she isn't deceitful of her friends. Also, if she did have any real feelings for Beast Boy, wouldn't she have revealed them in part one and to the end, while she was doing all those nice things with the rest of the Titans because she thought the world was going to end? But you're probably sick of hearing me dismiss this idea of Beast Boy and Raven being together. So let's get a second opinion from Strebiskunk.
Regarding whether or not Raven and Beast Boy were meant to be a romantic item in the cartoon, that's kind of funny because I remember thinking the same thing when I saw the episodes as they first came out, and it's a popular theory because they definitely had a number of moments where they grew closer and gained a better understanding of each other. But what I think is really interesting is that the comic book at the time was actually being influenced by the cartoon. For instance, Raven had already been dead for a long time in the comic series, but they ended up bringing her back because she was one of the most popular characters on the show. And later on in the comic, we learn that Raven and Beast Boy did start dating each other. Unfortunately, we really don't see much of it happening. They have their first kiss, and then the story skips ahead 1 year after they've already broken up. So I think if that's any indication, then even if they had gotten together on the show, it probably wouldn't have lasted.
Thanks, Strebiskunk. In closing, Raven and Beast Boy do make for a nice pairing. They are clearly the most different of all of the Titans, and therefore they offset each other very well. And despite the way that they often tease one another, they are clearly good friends. They are also the two fan favorites, and certainly my two favorite characters. But as for them being in love, I personally just don't see it.